If you want to stay updated about our channel, then please subscribe and hit that bell. Please enjoy the video. For the dive equipment setup, start by inspecting the scuba tank and check all the numbers on the tank. Especially check the hydrostatic test date and check your visual inspection, making sure that all the dates are correct. Check if the O-ring is in there and that it is in great condition. Then check the tank valve which way is open and closed, and give it a little burst to clean the valve. Once that's okay, grab your BCD at the BCD handle, put your safety strap away, and then correctly place the BCD over your scuba tank. Make sure that it's at least 4 fingers from the top, and then close the buckle. Double check if everything is attached. Make sure that the tank valve is parallel with the BCD handle. Place on the safety strap and tighten the safety strap accordingly. Again, double check your BCD handle that it's parallel to your tank valve. You can also check if the tank is not too high or too low by placing your hand and fingers at the top of your valve and your BCD. Now, to make sure that everything is attached correctly, grab your BCD tank or the handle of your BCD and then give it a little wiggle. Just make sure you be careful of your back. Grab your regulator, unscrew the dust cap from the first stage. Make sure that the two breathing hoses are on the right side of the right shoulder of your BCD. Place the first stage over the valve and then gently screw until it's closed. Now, it's very important, do not do this too tight. So only 3 fingers tight. It's all okay if your first stage moves a little bit before we open up the tank. Then attach the low pressure inflator hose by pulling back the top of your low pressure inflator hose and connecting it to your inflator hose of the BCD. Make sure afterwards you streamline it. Once it's all streamlined, looks in order, grab your alternate air source and attach your alternate air source at the right spot of your BCD. Make sure the yellow is shining outwards. Now, if everything looks good, before we open up the tank, turn your SPG away from you, so the glass, in the unlikely event, if it damages, it cannot hurt anybody. Hold down the inflator bottom of the BCD and then slowly open up the tank, instantly releasing the inflator button of the BCD. All the way open up the tank until the end. Now, do a full check of your dive equipment by fully inflating the BCD first until air escapes from the BCD, and then wait a second. Make sure there's no leaks. Squeeze it a little bit. So now we check that air actually goes in and that there's no leaks. Then deflate the BCD by releasing all the air. Then check if it also works orally. By putting a bit of air in there, a couple of breaths is enough. Make sure you press down the deflator button when you breathe in. Once that's all okay, then deflate the BCD again. Then grab your second stage in your right hand and your SPG in your left hand. Clean your second stage by perching a little bit, then smelling it, making sure that the air is not contaminated. And then put your second stage in your mouth and breathe in slowly and deeply a few times while looking at your air gauge. Your air gauge needle should stay still. If it moves, then there is a problem. If it is all okay, then put your second stage down again, take out your alternate air source, and repeat the process. Gently breathe in and out, making sure that everything is okay. Replace the alternate air source and make sure that everything is streamlined again. Then, after it's all good and streamlined, gently place your equipment on its side, make a nice little package out of it. As compact as possible. Now, when it all looks good and done, you can walk away. For the giant stride, stand with your toes on the side of the pool, with your fins sticking over. Make sure that everything is clear below you. Put a little bit of air into your BCD, 50%. Once that's okay, left hand on the buckle of your weight belt, right hand palm of the hand, second stage, two fingers on your mask. When you're ready, look forward and then big step forward until you go into the water. Once you reach the surface, keep your mask on and your second stage in your mouth. First, fully inflate your BCD by pressing the inflator button until you hear the sound. And then whenever you're ready, switch to your snorkel and give a big okay to the people still standing on the side. For the buoyancy check on the surface, communicate to your body that you're about to perform the buoyancy check. Put your second stage into your mouth. Then deflate your BCD while holding a normal breath. You should sink down, but be neutrally buoyant at around eye level. If that's the case, then you're properly weighted for the dive. Then, after you perform the scale, fully inflate your BCD again. If you experience a cramp, maybe in your leg or in your foot, on the surface, then make sure you have your mask and your snorkel in. Grab the top of your fin, stretch your leg and pull it backwards as much as you can. In many cases, it really works if you do it yourself, but if it doesn't work out, use your body. Now your body can do it for you and can also massage your calf at the same time. Start by signaling to your body that you're okay to go down. Then look around you and orientate yourself. Make sure that you also look down, that there's nothing below you. Everything is clear. Then at step 3, switch from your snorkel to your regulator. Clear your regulator second stage. Then on the next step, check your dive computer or your dive watch. And on step number 5, equalize, elevate, deflate your BCD to descent. On this descent, we're doing a visual reference. In this case, we're using the side of the pool as a visual reference to slowly go down. Make sure that once in a while you look below you, equalize your ears, stay close to your body, and keep looking at the side of the pool to keep an eye on that visual reference and stay close. Make sure you don't touch anything. Once you get close to the bottom, make sure you don't touch the bottom and go in perfect horizontal trim position. Once you're there, communicate to your body to buddy up and to start the dive. During the dive, you might experience a cramp in your leg. If that happens, make contact to your body and communicate clearly that you have a problem in your leg. Try to remove the cramp yourself by pulling the top of your fin backwards and stretching your leg. But it's much more easier if your body helps you. Massage your calf until you release the cramp. And then continue your dive. Make sure that you put a little bit of air into your BCD. Slowly breathe in and see if you rise. If not, just put a little bit more air into your BCD by pressing the LPI inflator button. Slowly breathe in until you rise. When you start rising, slowly start to exhale until you go down, and when you slowly inhale, you will go up again. By breathing normally, you will stay in one place. Make sure you do not kick and scull your arms, so streamline it either way you like it, by crossing your legs and putting your hands together. Remember, just breathe in and out gently on a normal pace, and you should stay in one area. Remember again, do not touch the bottom, do not touch the surface. After 30 seconds, deflate your BCD, and then you end the skill. Make sure that you're neutrally buoyant. By having enough air into your BCD, gently breathing in and out. Do not touch the bottom, do not touch the surface. Make sure you're streamlined. Have really, really good trim by being as horizontal as possible. Scissor kicks are effective fin kicks, but we do recommend to use the frog kick. Again, don't use your hands to swim. Streamline yourself as much as you can by holding your hands in front of you, or maybe have them on the side of your body. Keep double checking that you're still streamlined, so you don't touch the bottom or the surface, and that you are horizontal. There you go. Now you're swimming with a perfect trim. Keep swimming around the pool. And remember, if you go from shallow to deep, exhale slowly. Make sure you equalize your ears once in a while and adjust any air in your BCD if needed. When you realize that you're out of air, make contact to your body and signal clearly that you're out of air. Your body will now supply the alternate air source. Make sure that the hose is above the arm. Switch over from your second stage to the alternate air source, blowing bubbles in between, and clear the alternate air source either way you like. Make sure you stay close to each other by having a Roman arm shake. Communicate to each other that you're okay to swim around. You'll be swimming around for 1 minute, so make sure you do not touch the sides, the bottom or the surface, and have really good swim together. Make sure that you look at each other once in a while, but also briefly interrupt it by looking forward so you don't swim into anything else. Keep staying close together and keep a watchful eye to each other. Also, once in a while, communicate to each other if you're still okay. Slowly keep swimming around. Keep communicating. After 1 minute, signal to each other that you're okay to go up. Stay close to each other with a Roman arm shake. Elevate your LPI. Deflate your BCD and slowly swim up to the surface. Stay close to each other and make sure that you keep looking up, that everything is clear. Once you reach the surface, keep kicking your legs effectively so you stay up on the surface. Then make sure you keep having contact. The person that is not out of air fully inflates your BCD normally and help your body to stay up. And the one that's out of air, take out your alternate air source and orally inflate your BCD until you're fully inflated and positively buoyant. Start the CISA by being neutrally buoyant and in a good ascent position. Right hand above your head, left hand on the deflator button. Then take a couple of deep breaths in. Whenever you're ready, take a final breath and start swimming slowly while exhaling continuously, making a sound. It's the best sound that you can use. Keep swimming slowly without touching the bottom or the surface. And keep exhaling, making that continuous sound. Swim for at least 9 meters until the CISA is finished. Whenever you're ready, make contact with your body. Grab your air gauge, tap on your air gauge to ask the air of your body. Your body will give the amount of air. Make sure you're okay to it, that you understand that person. And now the body will ask you. Give him your amount of air and make sure that your body gives you an okay so you understand. Then continue the dive. The first thing that you do is to fully inflate your BCD. Then lay on your back and open up your weight belt. Then under the water behind your back, take it off. Remember not to drop it. Keep it close to your body so you keep your balance. Then make sure that the weight belt is not twisted or anything, and then put it back. Make sure that you give the buckle to your left hand and the open hand is in your right hand. Keep laying on your back and reconnect the weight belt. Make sure that the SPG is not in between the weight belt. Double check if all the weights are okay, evenly displaced, and nothing is entangled. Start by closing off your scuba tank completely. Turn off the air all the way. Once it's turned off, take out your alternate air source. Hold it with your right hand and then your second stage in your left hand. Perch. At exactly the same time, both second stages, until all the air is released from the hoses and the first stage. Gently put it on the floor. Unstreamline your LPI hose and disconnect it by pulling back the top of the LPI and gently disconnect it. Then gently unscrew your first stage from the tank valve. And then, very important, remember to dry that dust cap from any water, so no water can enter your first stage. We recommend using a dry cloth or towel for this one. Once it's okay, place back the dust cap on the first stage. Double check everything from any leaks, and once that's okay, you can use what we call a spaghetti loop technique to make a nice little loop out of your regulator system and then gently put it on the floor. Then release your safety strap, take it off the tank valve, then hold on to the BCD with one hand, release the tank strap, and remove the BCD from the tank cylinder. Gently put it on the floor again and make a nice little package out of it. Then grab the tank and very gently put it on its side on the floor so it can't fall over anymore. Put your BCD and the regulator together. Double check if everything is streamlined. And then you can walk away.